Welcome. What are we looking at today? Looking at another one from Elysian. This one is their Night Owl Pumpkin Ale. And I believe like the other one, our award-winning pumpkin ale, brewed with pumpkin and spiced in conditioning with nutmeg, clove, cinnamon, ginger, and allspice, weighing in at 6.7%. And I'm going to use this to open it because it also doubles as a coaster. Ta-da! It also has a magnet on it. I don't hear. Especially we can get some good head for bad. I don't know, he's probably disappointed in that. Well, it definitely has shit floating around in it. I'm sure there's like a technical name other than shit that they would like used, but a personal favorite. Just seemed like very, very pumpkin-y. Go figure. Cheers. That's not bad. With the, wow, I almost bumped right into those. Took my hair out. By adding things like the cinnamon, you know, they kind of bring up the, it's not, you know, it's sweet by the makeup of the spices in it, but not necessarily sweet like you filled it with sugar. That clove, cinnamon, nutmeg, all burn as in like a jet taking off. I'm just Captain Analogy today. I'll be here all week. Or will I? Yeah? Today marks the countdown. If I do one each day between now and next Thursday, that'll be it. Could possibly be it forever, you know, depending on if the plane stays in the air or not, or if I'm even able to get on the plane because I'm on a no-fly list. Because that's the way America is now. If you're a patriot, you're considered a threat. And I love it that we just keep tossing around that word. A threat to democracy. Well, you know, we're not a democracy. Constitutional Republic. Find the words democracy one time in the Constitution. Okay, let's see, I'm actually going to start over at the, starting at this channel, but comments that got missed, 20 hours ago, Usher Meyer says, goodnight, King, sir, and then, Din says, yeah, girl, he likes Black Hawk. Okay, That's great, Din. Thank you. The light's green over there, so we get to go back over here. How is that a thing? Oh, I guess it could have been. 6 days ago, Mike said, well, I had more drinks before 9 a.m., man. Shocking. You and Matt, you can start on your drinking Olympics. Then Mike says, fuck yeah, put Everclear in everything, man. This is all on the classic cola from Not Your Father's. And then, again, 6 days ago on the same video, Usher Meyer says, good night, King. Good night, sir. Sorry I missed all that. While we keep going, Mike says, Eric always needs adult watchover. Yeah. I also have some wrinkles on my member that I need worked out, too. 6 days ago, Tom says my highest electric bill was $211. I think that's about in the ballpark. The one that we just had was $220, $221. You know, 110, 120, you know, whatever it takes. See. Okay. Let me get rid of this. On the Brett's Bloody Mary mix, first in is Rich saying cheers all. Rich, your name has been tossed around on the short list of potential guesses on arriving. I'm sorry to say that I didn't put you on the list because, again, there's certain people that I'm sorry, I don't mean, there's no offense. Actually, it's all honor. When I say, if this whole fucking thing turns out to be, oh, surprise, it's like Jeremy and Caitlin, or surprise, it's Jolson and Teresa. Actually, I now know that it's not, I know it's not Jolson for sure, because Jolson called this morning and wanted to know if he could come hang Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and I said, you're more than welcome to. I have to go to work on Tuesday. Or do I? Yeah, I probably should. But, yeah. I don't know, Christine's having way too much fun with this, but that's fine. So I took a shit on her pillow and mushed it in between the two of them and put it back in there. I wouldn't do such a thing. But yeah, she's, my hoping, I know, is not happening. So now I'm back to my guessing. We're right by the time you see this. By the time you see this, they may or may not be here. Or him, he, she, the, them, they. That's what Christine keeps saying. I'm like, is it them? Well, it could be them. It could be him. Could be her. Could be they. Again, no disrespect, but one of the other big guesses by a few people was Jules. I believe she was still in Guam a couple days ago, and I know it's really, really expensive. Like, I think that Jules would be happy to pay what Sharky would have to pay to get here from Guam. Jules was a guess. Not on my list, because again, I'd probably be more pissed to find out that it was it's Jules, and it's being like a surprise. No, it's not a surprise. It's like Jules would be like coming home. Like Jeremy and Caitlin, it'd be coming home. It's not a surprise. It pissed me off. Like, oh, it's just them. I'm just kidding. Ah, fuck, I thought finally one of these years I was gonna get away with 5 days off and not have to deal with Jeremy and Caitlin. Well, Jeremy's okay. Caitlin's fucking pain in the ass. I mean, even Jeremy makes her go sit in the truck sometimes. Let's see. David says, next to first. Being truthful, yeah. She's the one that body-wise is okay, boobs, I don't know, almost too big, but we are talking, when like 50% of a gigantic boob is the pepperoni, I'd rather not. Just go straight to the core. Multi-Gunman says, insert comment here. Okay. Hi, I'm Multi-Gunman, and if I'm not twirling a 357 Magnum and sucking on a glass of whiskey, I'm a homo. Mr. 27, subcomment to him, says, naked non-ninja. what was here. And then he says he's drinking beer. Mike says cheers. Cheers, Mike. Bat says greetings, Captain. Greetings, Bat. Rich says, nope, no tattoos. Thank you. It's like a real doll, but warmer. J-Dog's here at work. J-Dog. J-Dog has been notified that lasagna dinner is on Saturday. Here's what I can tell you. Excuse me. Jolson and family are camping, but evidently he by himself is going to be up here on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday if he wants. I don't give a shit. Hey, geez. If I cannot trust Jolson by this point in time, I can't trust anybody. So, Jolson, free reign, baby. Saturday. I know Wendy and her boyfriend. I mean, it is about time. I mean, geez, what is it now been? I can't even guess. 4? 5? Years since Christopher was tragically lost. Sounds like she might be bringing little Christopher with, which little Christopher is not so little anymore. I wish I had the video evidence to see him crying like a little bitch shooting a .22 long rifle. Sorry, Christopher. These days, he'd be like, yeah, get me out there. I'd like to get me out there. Maybe in the next 5 days we'll get some of that in. Problem is, if it's too many people, the only option, well, we sort of have the secret northern Wisconsin range as an option, since how I am a member, and as of right now, my fees have gone towards nothing, unless you count me and NIHAP being there and prepaying. Or post-paying. Yeah, post-paying for when we're there. Otherwise, we have to go to the shack. To the shack, baby. Otherwise, I've been working on trying to make sure things are prepared house-wise for Christine. I have yet to do a trial run to see if this monster will fit in the new bag, and then making sure that I have all the electronics I have. I am going to assume, Mr. Solar, I haven't talked to him, but I'm going to assume that he has a tripod, so I am not going to waste time trying to figure out how to bring one of those, but I will bring the little, my phone holder, because if you see me for a brewery view out there, I still, to this moment in time, cannot remember if I just uploaded it straight or if we did YouTube Live. I have no recollection of those events. John says he's got 6 or 8 cameras and he's got the computer and whatever. I guess we could use whatever software he uses. I guess now that I think about it, I could put a few things on a thumb drive, which I also do not have. Or I could use this guy to transfer them onto one of the cards, and I could bring a few. I don't even need to bring Brew Girls with. I just have to go over to the Captain Dick Nozzle Messenger group and download, 50 or 75 things for the morning dump from Brad. So it'd just be a matter of some of the openers, but I guess, who even cares, I guess. They could just be, here I am. I mean, it was fun when I was at Jolson's, being able to actually do my regular editing and stuff like that. Made for some late nights, though. What the hell happened to this beer? Better use a Sharky's opener. You know, I gotta stay in practice. Oh, bad. Look at that. Oh, we're growing. Mushroom stamping the... Oof. Oh, God. Bad. Do you need a moment? A tissue? Or a... You know, a sheet? I don't know. Guess it depends. Oh, God, yeah. Mmm! God. Yes. Like to play Little Airplane and come on in for a landing, if you know what I mean. Am I in a bad mood? No, I'm not in a bad mood today. I'm in a pretty good mood. Oh, before I forget, because don't know what it is, but Louder with Crowder, listening to his latest show, which he actually wasn't on. Very interesting. He refuses to announce, but he says he is going to have a show coming up on a subject that absolutely will be a complete game changer in the upcoming Olympics. What the fuck? Looking at those breasts going, I could hold them in the air for 15 minutes, I bet. upcoming election. And Matt made breakfast for me and Christine. I made Christine breakfast first, which that's good. Brought it over so she could have that, and then he made me breakfast. Michelle next door is gone for the weekend, and her grandson, which I'm like, grandson, who is a senior this year over at Denfeld, he's staying because he's overseeing Tommy, her dog, and he was out walking Tommy this morning at, it must have been around 7:40. And Matt's like, hey, have you had anything to eat? Well, I was going to go home and have breakfast. What are you going to have, cereal? Matt goes, come on, make you bacon, eggs. I keep the hash browns that didn't get cooked. Fire them up for him. And he's like, well, evidently he can't have eggs. But he said, I'm all for the bacon. There's some brownie points won. Yeah, just like most things, I would have been okay. Wondering what this would have been like if we would have maybe said, heck with the cinnamon. I mean, in some cases, I am all about cinnamon being all over my tongue. In this particular scenario, not really. Then after breakfast, watched, yeah. Okay, moving on, sorry. Just, yeah. Sharky, I don't know if we've ever had a conference on this one, but, yeah. Tom says, Hola, senor, can you tell me which way it is to Texas? I go see welfare office. Gracias, taxpayer. Again, I am very fascinated to find out what Crowder, what documentary or what evidence or what he's planning on showing that is, I don't know. I just laugh, though, when I hear the libtards talk about how, oh, that didn't matter to Trump, and that's not going to matter to Trump, and, oh, the whole thing with RFK, that doesn't change anything. Yeah, so I'm really wondering what the, what he's got going. I told Matt, I said, well, I hope he's got a guy that makes sure the brakes on his car are good and checked, but I guess him and his staff are very, very vocal on the fact that anytime they do any research and they come up with stuff, not a single one person is in possession of the total story or what the evidence or whatever it is that they have. They're like, you know what? Here's what's really sad. The Democratic Party, the deep state, they are the ones. I mean, if you want to bring forth any evidence that you have seen this on the other side, not saying that it doesn't exist, but why, when you think of deep state corruption in our politics, you constantly think that, why is it that maybe the Republican Party has really battled over the years? Oh, because the Republicans usually will not resort to killing somebody so that they can maintain their power and their corruption over us. Do little test things like maybe have some Wuhan stuff, this celebration, and then find out how gullible the masses are. All those Karens and Chads out there, the ones that are still walking around with a fucking diaper on your face. If you seriously don't think that was a test run to find out how easily it would be to do anything that they want, because of how gullible people are, how hook, line, and sinker some people are. Well, I'd like to go all the way back to the beginning. If you could find the first, well, that's right, they deleted my channel twice. If you could go all the way back to when I first started talking about it, and everyone was like, oh, no, you're just a conspiracy theorist, there's nothing wrong, why would the government ever, ever want to use you all as guinea pigs? Because they don't give a shit about you at all. You can't even say they give a shit about you because you make them money. They'll just print more fucking money. They don't give a fuck. Just goodbye, peoples! We're gonna introduce this, that, and the other thing! Oh, yeah! Hey, we can't possibly cure really bad things, because then people will live longer, and we can't have that as long as us in power. As long as we live and we have our little social structures and we worship the devil and we get the weak-minded to do our bidding. Wow. Impressed how many people fell for it. How many people continue to fall for it? Me? Never. Yeah, I'm bragging that I had been thrown out of some places because I refused to wear the diaper. But even places like that wanted to sort of believe knew that, well, let's see, if I say something to this guy, there's a chance that, well, he's just going to take his money and go spend it somewhere else. So, other than that, I guess I got nothing. Yes. Yeah, baby. Bad says, no tattoos. Thank you, sir. It's just a simple question I wanted to ask, and I always like it when if I ask a question and actually get some feedback. Tom says the vodka is a good value. I use it in my drinks. Then he says, I have one on my upper arm, but I got it a long time ago when no one got tattoos. Mine is an eagle soaring with its talons outstretched.
I mean, it's sort of like, say, that, yeah. That's cool. That's cool.
Like I said, I have one, and if it wasn't for the fact that guns and optics, gun accessories, ammunition, guns in general, get in the way of it. I mean, even something like these days, you know, I was thinking about, and I don't know if there's an appropriate side to put it on or whatever, but my Celtic cross. I've always wanted to do the Celtic cross, and I found one, and it was on a computer that I believe that I don't know if I still have the original image, and it was a particular, you know, Celtic design in the cross, but yeah, I always wanted to do something like that. Other than that, nah, not really. I mean, some of these people, I mean, for instance, Gage's mom's boyfriend, Bob, he's one of those guys that's just, I don't know, it just looks like it was, make some, like, blocky lightning bolts and go all the way down to the end of your fingers and stuff like that kind of stuff, and I mean, you'll know I've gone completely off the fucking deep end if you ever see a tattoo above where my shirt line would be. Anything on the neck? Fuck no. On your face? Nah, I mean, Tom McDonald, for instance, I mean, I don't know if he's ever been asked if he could go back in time. Would you have skipped some of that stuff, like tattooing your eyelids and on that kind of thing? I remember, something in my eye. Remember my friend's brother was always jokingly, well, we thought jokingly, talked about the eyeball that he had tattooed on the end of his dick, and it turned out to be true because his wife at the time used to bitch that it always looks like it's staring at me when I'm sucking it. And I was like, okay, that was information I really, really did not need to know. J-Dog, Midway USA has 7mm Psalm, cheapest is $109 for 20 shots. That actually, J-Dog isn't hideous for that round, but to know that it would cost plus shipping, it would, like what we did the up at the shack that day. I mean, the whole thing was, is I would put in three rounds, and that's all that we were gonna shoot. One for Sharky, one for you, and then one for me. And then Sharky just fucking went, you know, full auto. That's fine though. I mean, he came an awful long way. I would be. I told him after just having fun and giving him shit that I would have let him burn the whole box if he wanted to, but yeah, it's, well, I guess technically, yeah, if you can find it, like, for instance, John's son Sean, who I think there is now trouble in paradise and he's not speaking to that son. Sean was doing it at $3 a round for me, so that's 60, so almost almost, but not half the price. I mean, maybe when you figure in shipping, unless Midway USA had some kind of a deal where if you spent $200 or whatever, but hey, but you did answer a question. Someone at a large company actually has it in stock. And I personally think, unfortunately, it kind of follows, like all of them, 6.5 Creedmoor. 6.5 Creedmoor was not an out-the-door beast. So if the seven psalm gets in the hand of a few right people, and then other people are like, well, he's shooting that, maybe I need to look into it. All I'm telling you is if you can afford the ammo, because the rifle doesn't really change much depending on what setup. Like I said, if I could do anything, I would probably, even though I know there's a few people that are smarter than me financially that think it's an absolutely a sell it. But like John said, you know, this, I mean, if you can afford to feed it, you know, especially being able to actually have some fun, not just be able to afford to have a bunch of ammo on hand, but actually be able to get out and have some fun with it. He's just like, not going to be any different than anything else. That's why it came with the dies, because John didn't rely on somebody else to come up with a good price or somewhere that he could go. John would just go, if he shot 20 rounds on a Saturday afternoon, on Sunday he would resize, clean, resize, reload, and just do it all over again. I personally have never reloaded a rifle round. I helped with John, and my brand new set of 308 dies that I had, I mean, hell, John spent well over an hour just getting the dies ready to be used. Some high-end special, he was wearing a fucking respirator outside cleaning the dies. That was when he loaded me up a few of I think I have them all in cases. When he loaded me up a few of these, and then Jay at Elite Ammunition finished. He didn't finish all that I have in projectiles. I think I still have a few of these projectiles left, but I have what, 100 loaded, 100 rounds of these, and I have never successfully put one of these on target. And I believe what the problem is the day that I said aim 3 1/4 reticle slashes down and squeeze the trigger, and when I did that with these, I never hit. But I think the problem was is somehow I stupidly assumed that, oh, I had to step it up, but I didn't. I think these fly so flat that I should have been trying more for a direct shot or one reticle. But no, at the 550 yard, I never did hit it with one of these that day. But thank you, J-Dog. Maybe if I actually start having something called surplus money. You know, when Camel Toe Harris is completely disgraced. I mean, here's one thing, because if you're one of these people that are sitting back listening to the fucking lying media in the deep state, I mean, how is CNN, ABC, NBC, all of these fucking pawns for the deep state, how is this not intimidation? How is this not, they just like this like Suckleberg admitted when they squelched the laptop thing. How many people would never have voted for Biden knowing the truth that all got covered up? Now all of a sudden it's like, oh, she's doing so good. And you've got the racist, the ultimate racist, and I don't give a flying fuck if you are offended or not, the most racist people in the United States right now is a certain sector of black people. Fucking racist, racist, racist. When you feel that you are being intimidated because you're proud to be fucking white. Yeah, guess what? I'm proud to be fucking white. Fuck you. Eat a dick. A big white one. Fucker. So, you got these, just the ultimate racists right now, these black people that are just, no, don't even pretend you don't know exactly who I'm talking about. Well, they're the ones going around saying that, fuck it, anybody that's black that votes for Trump, you are this, that, and the other thing. Hey, just keep showing off how racist you truly are. Because first of all, if you're basing your election on one of three things. One, you couldn't possibly vote for Trump because you have fallen hook, line, and sinker for the fucking lies. You know, if more people could actually, someone set them, maybe it would take someone like God to set them down and say, listen, you were told that he's this. It's a fucking lie. You were told that he was involved in this. That's a fucking lie. You were told that he's racist. That's a fucking lie. The amount of lies, the continuous lies about Donald Trump, and the man continues to fight with everything that he's been through, and they have thrown everything at him, and they still can't fucking touch him. That's right. Bulletproof Don. Fuck. Yep. The Democratic Party is just an embarrassment. And they I'm happy about it. They are showing who they are to the smart, the intelligent, the black people that have the brain power to actually look into things for themselves. Like I've constantly said now for fucking years, if more people used this and actually looked, instead of just assuming the lies that they are being told by the ABCs and the CNNs out there, it wouldn't even be a landslide. It would be like, yeah, five people in the United States voted for Kamala Harris. And, yeah. Because that's all it's been, is just nothing but an onslaught of lies about Trump. And then, oh, all of a sudden, man, Kamala Harris is just fucking better than soft butter on bread. What's her platform? Because right now, everything that she's doing, she's stealing. She's stealing Trump's ideas. I mean, we're up to like three big ones as of right now that she has taken credit for. That is, it's like, again, it's Obama. Obama all over again. Tell a lie long enough and the sheep will believe it to be the truth. Don't want the Coke, but give her a poke. J-Dog, made it this far, not flying, probably be okay to continue not. What? I sense you want something. Okay. $5. J-Dog, no tats. That's gun. Okay. So this is why me and J-Dog are friends. because as right now, well, first of all, right now I just flat out need $650 because I have to put an HK VP9 SK in Christine's collection because it will after over a fucking decade, it will be the carry gun. So that's about the average of a decent tattoo these days. I mean, a decent one. That's probably what my Celtic Cross would cost me, let alone start doing some idiotic sleeving or anything like that. But yeah, J-Dog, right now, if somebody said, I have $1,000, you can either get a Hellion or a Hellion. No, you didn't even hear me out. Okay, I have $1,000. You can either get the Springfield Hellion. You're not letting me finish. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. $1,000. I'm gonna hand you $1,000, but you can only do one of two things. You can either get your the Hellion. I give up. Yeah, that would have to be bagged and tagged. I'm sorry. Salty. One small step for man, one giant leap for nakedness. Miss 27 says, By the way, McLean, you're welcome. I could have easily been done by now. Whiny bitch. What? I said, it would be nice to be rich. Mr. Mark Mac 85, Harris is just as evil as the rest of the administration. Trump 2024. Damn right. And I like how, things that are coming out right now, and, people like us that are reporting the news are like, let's not forget that that this whole thing was started by the Biden-Harris administration. But when you watch CNN and they talk about, like Zuckerberg says that and here's the two different things. CNN reporting, Zuckerberg came out and said that the Biden administration forced him to, and you hear anybody else but the bought and paid for anti-Trump media, you know, the ones that are trying to change an election interference. How is it not election interference? Please, someone go. You get somebody like, say, the older millennial or one of the people that I follow on TikTok, that evil thing where I get all of my information. He says, Mark Zuckerberg said that he was told to by the Biden-Harris administration. Whenever you hear anybody in a deep state player for the media, they say the Biden administration. Anybody else says the Biden-Harris administration, because the sheep somehow are like, oh yeah, when she takes office, she's gonna fix all the things that I just don't want to come out loud and say that I'm wrong, because then it would look like I fucked up when I voted for Biden in the first place. Uh-huh. What? Smile Money, you had COVID-19, so something was inserted in your body that didn't have any research, you know, except for Chinese viral. Oh, sorry. Well, I'll put it this way, Smile Money. Whatever I had was more mild than the typical flu, didn't last as long as the typical flu, and the only reason that I'm even saying that it was that was because someone gave me a test kit. One of the test kits that I used, I actually saw a video where they tested a banana and it had COVID. So I don't know.
All I know is if what I had was really COVID, I would rather have that than the flu from a few years ago. Mr. Mark Max says, zero tattoos on me. Thank you, sir. Appears to be no tattoos on that either, seems how we can see about 90% of it. Smile Money, Matt will be living in a van down by the river if something happens to Grandma. That is why I worry for him and his son. Well, don't worry about his son. His son has mom. I mean, he just won't come over and visit if it's not a two-bedroom van with internet so that they can do their gaming. Smile Money, I had hoped to attend the Shootapalooza, but that dream ended. Those events resulted in some of the best videos. To be in one of those group photos would have been a bucket list item. Now I'm just too old, and if Jerry can't make it so much for meeting a dancing leprechaun. Smile Money, it would be an honor for you to attend one. The problem is, as of this point in time, maybe next year. See, it's out of my control. But Mama Bear wants to do a reunion, which, unfortunately, that going off of the definition of reunion, that would mean that the only people that will be invited to a Shootapalooza would be people that had been here in the past. Personally, I would be asked, I would personally ask, since how I do, I am 50% of the relationship, maybe come up with a couple of markers that I could maybe, like poker chips, that I could call in and say, listen, there's a couple of people, I realize they've never been here, but we're not getting any younger. And I've already lost the opportunity because of that. Rise Arms lost the opportunity to the plan was for him to come to the Shootapalooza. Unfortunately, he never made it. So, I guess we'll see. I know there's at least one on the horizon. How long does a line keep? Seems to really be living the good life down here in this fridge. What's Trump 2024? Grab him by the pussy. See how this thing works. Just like Trump is a president, works great. I just love that bullshit. The only reason that Trump's administration looked good is because of that curve. It was all everything Obama did. Fuck you, you fucking idiots. Yeah, okay, please. 4 more years of what we've been through. You want to call me an extremist? You want me to call whatever you want to call me? This country will not survive 4 more years of the deep state. We need Trump in office to expose as many of them as possible and punish them in any way possible, either by prison or financially ruin them.
Cobra, no tats yet, but there is always tomorrow. I sort of feel that way. Poco says, we're both here. Excellent. Then Mrs. Poco says, oh my god, that opening was too funny. I don't even remember which one I even used. That was like 14 hours ago. Matt Davis says, no tats on me. Thank you, Matt. Mrs. Poco again, have a great time in Maine. I'm jealous. $4 lobsters are in my dreams. I'm from Maine originally. Awesome. Yeah, there's... See, you know... And like John said, if you think what we are eating here is either A, the real thing, or B, fresh, you're kidding yourself. And out there... John, I hope you hear me say this. 4 weeks, 1 month, I hope I can say, God, no, I could not eat another lobster. And I'm assuming that somewhere between you and the last generations, that your clam chowder or seafood bisque is really good, but I throw this challenge out there. Let's go to wherever you think the best you can get at a restaurant is, and then I want to compare it with what you make. I could fucking eat lobster, shrimp, scallops. Every fucking day. I mean, like Christine. Pizza. Hey, I managed a Domino's pizza for more than a decade. One way or the other, I bet you I had a slice of pizza every single day. For sure, I had pizza every day that I worked, so that was at least 5 days a week. And as a manager, what does it mean when you... Hey, throw me in a large pepperoni, onion, mushroom, jalapeno, and I'll be up in like a half an hour to get that. On my day off, as the manager, not only did I go to the goddamn store, but I had pizza. So, if you think that I could not eat lobster or seafood every single day for a month, au contraire. McLean, Eric, I think it's about time we go to another couple's retreat. McLean, my snowblower doesn't work, but my yogurt thrower just won't quit. Okay, moving on. McLean, I have tattoos. That eyeball? Sorry. Jolson says, we need cowbell. Wade, do you know that the FBI put out a memo that said anyone using the term Second Amendment was potentially a domestic terrorist? No, I didn't, but I think I... Yes. And sure. Did I not just say? Isn't it sad that that government, that the democratic libtard government... considers anybody that is a patriot to be a threat to them, and we have to be silenced. Well, I hate to go out on a limb, and I'm gonna have to smile money this so you can read between the lines, but if I had the power and the group, I would silence anybody that thought that I, as a patriot, was a threat to our republic. Those people need to be silenced. Wade, no tattoos on me. Not surprised, Wade, but I thought there might be a, you know, at least one. Or maybe even alcohol was involved, and then he woke up and... Mr. 27 says 35th. Then EMT with a fucking novel says, for your snowblower, do you use regular unleaded gas or ethanol-free? I use the regular in everything until I went to use my chainsaw one day. It started up just fine and idled great, but as soon as I touched the chain to the log, it sounded like I had drug it through the dirt, which I had not. Researching found that regular corn gas was probably the issue for small engines. I dumped it and filled it with the EF, and it runs like brand new. After I had a tank work through it to clean out the shit out of it. I had to run my snowblower on half choke for an entire time that I used it for just to get it to run right on corn gas. Started putting EF in all my small engines and the chainsaw, and the snowblower fixed itself too. Ethanol free. To answer your question, I've always used either premium or unleaded in them. I thought the E85 and shit was the corn stuff. And you're saying make sure not to use any gas that's made with corn. Alright. I will have to check and get back to you. I know I generally just use unleaded at the pump. Sharky, cheers all. Shot that a few times more than planned. Here we go. That would be the psalm. That's fine. We should have all shot it more that day, but 100 yards was of absolutely no challenge. It was more like, instead of trying to hit the target, we should have just been trying to hit the hole made by the previous person. Sharky, with no tats, I have no tats or piercings. I thought about it when I was trying out for the Apache pilot program in 1995. If I had made it, I would have had a tat of the squadron patch. I didn't make it, so now I just have a tat of a guy taking it in the ass. Just kidding. I have no tats. Even now and then, I try to lick and nibble them off of some parts of others. Well done. We have to know if you can lick a tattoo off, is all I can say. Sharky SH from over this side of the pond. Laugh out loud, classic outro poster. Okay, well, you better be over there, but then again, I would be... Okay. And bad with the last comment, hour and third, yes. Just, she's... She might be my number one in of 8,175 pictures in this. Bad, it says, Eric and Matt went up the hill to fetch a case of beer. Eric fell down and cracked the frown, and Matt came stumbling after. Okay, hitting the button, I'm guessing two of you. Three of you with four comments. Five comments. Because one of you had three comments. Okay, where do I put this? It's not bad. Again, I would be, if I was making this, oh, it's unfiltered and may contain sediment. More like unfiltered and will contain sediment. Like, duh. It's almost like Democratic libtard. Maybe a worthless piece of shit, anti-American, hates patriots, and will do anything to get and maintain power. Award-winning, though. I would lighten up on the nutmeg, lighten up on the clove, skip the cinnamon, ginger, and allspice. Cool.
I mean, when you make a pumpkin pie, do you use cinnamon? I like the coffee one more. This is still very drinkable. Tastes very natural. I would give this a 7. I would give her like a 9.75. Stephen Bush's bitch. First in the club is Rich Huff saying cheers, clubbers. 39 minutes ago. Well, if Rich is the one coming up, this is well played, Rich. Throw in a club comment somewhere along the way up 35 north. Bad says, howdy, clubbers. Then Bad says,
fuck Joe Biden! Fuck Joe Biden! Fuck Joe Biden!
And fuck Kamala Harris and fuck Tampon Tim. I mean, in some cases, this bitch is doing all the work that we need to do. Again, I know I've already said this, but when I heard that she picked Tampon Tim, I'm like, yes! Some of this shit, some of the lies that don't seem to be escaping Minnesota or true patriots need people to hear. I mean, we were whatever the fuck in fertilization, yeah, it turned out that was a lie. I was over in the sand. Oh, that turned out to be a lie. When I was shooting weapons of war, that was a lie. I mean, they just go on and on. Not to mention, where'd all the money go, Tampon Tim, from the Feeding the Future program? Tim, where'd that go? It was all under your watch. You're a fucking embarrassment, and you should have resigned. But, thank you. Camel Toe Harris will be taking you with her. Bad, what is your favorite shotgun round? I like a number 4 for varmint control. Very effective with my full choke. Bad, I'm not really a shotgun person. I mean, someone like Jeremy with a fucking $1 million kick-ass shotgun probably can answer this in a heartbeat. Me? I don't know. I just like things that run in the links. I think it's badass. Then I've got the other badass one, the 735 Mossberg? 835? I don't see. It's right there, and I don't even know what the fuck it is. I just know I haven't even shot it yet. Slugs. Bad slugs. Or the PX, PDX, the PDX round. I mean, this is for the Lynx, and this, I was going to have the Lynx be the on-duty gun upstairs on my side of the bed, but right now I have a very, very kick-ass pump, and some people say the price of admission you are about to have a really fucking bad last of your life scenario is when you hear chick chick. So that's up there. That's up on my side of the bed, and it's loaded with PDX rounds. Otherwise, buckshot or slugs. Because if I'm going to shoot it, I want to feel the power. And it'll be too late by the time anyone hears this, but there is a shitload of ammunition on Twin Ports bid that ends tonight at 8 o'clock Central. And as of 2 hours ago when I checked it out, I could pick up more than 100 rounds of 454 Casull for less than $20. Granted, it's an auction, so the person that has the $9 bid in as of right now might fight it a little bit more. Then you got 50 rounds of 9mm that are already more
then the last time I bought Winchester, this is also all reload. So I think sometimes people are hesitant on that. I know if I have one fucking problem out of a million rounds loaded for me by Mikey, David's like, well, I wouldn't use that shit. Well, we had a whole bunch of primer problems the absolute worst squib yet was the one in Christine's 45 Long Colt. And I don't even remember if that was even a Mikey reload or not. I've had two now. I had a 45 and I had a 10 millimeter that I know where Mikey reloads that just, you know, I don't understand exactly what happened, but that was, I took a wooden dowel and I literally used my little rubber mallet, didn't even use a hammer, and I was holding the barrel in one hand and just went toof, and the projectile and the dowel just shot out, and I'm like, well, that was easy. So, I don't know. Oops. I don't know, you shoot enough, eventually it's, god damn, those are nice. It's gonna happen. But again, I might check at moments before it closes and throw one in there. You can't just wait for 30 seconds to go and put a bid in, because if it's a last minute bid, it starts a 1 or a 2 minute timer to see if the person that was originally interested is willing to get back into it. But 100 rounds of reloaded 454 Casules for possibly being able to get them for $20 seems like a no-brainer. But there was a whole bunch of 5.7 in there with Hornady projectiles in it. Bunch of Hornady 7.62x39, a bunch of 223, a bunch of 308s. Nice little crease in the love canal. Okay, last comment. David, no tats. I have well-earned scars that all come with a story. Excellent. Hitting the reload button and Bad just won't let her go. He says, last comment 2 minutes ago. And then he says, I am not fast enough to be first, but I am slow enough to be last. How would you like to be a popsicle, huh? Okay, well, we are effectively right now T-minus 2 hours and 40 minutes tops from him, her, they, them, with or without a dog, arriving for the big fucking surprise. It's probably more like a mind fuck than it will be a surprise. Again, the person that I put down on my list and on hers, same name, that would be a surprise. Who will probably show up is probably just going to end up being family. But I tell you what, you'll know tomorrow. Some of you will know tonight. Cheers.